more people potentially leaving 343, and the grassroots program gets some new additions. So stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving our news and informational video when it comes to Halo. If you like this kind of videos, make sure to tap that like button. It really helps out the video and channel so more people get a chance to stay in the know with everything going on with Halo. Well, let's start off with a bit of information that actually just happened today. And that is the revival of the grassroots program and how it kind of hints towards the release of Halo Infinite. So just today, Tashi went on Halo Waypoint, put up a blog talking about everything involving the grassroots program, where it's been. The last update was back in June of 2019, and so let us know now what's going on and what's going on with it in the future. So I'm gonna read this word for word just to ease off any kind of confusions with anything. About 1 year ago, we gave an update on all things Halo Esports, including the status of the future of the HCS grassroots program. At the time, we had pressed pause on bringing in new content creator partners into the program as we're working behind the scenes on an evolution to the program and how we work with content creators all together leading up to the launch of Halo Infinite. Those plans are still in the works and our intentions remain the same. However, the timing of those updates will be aligned more closely with the release of Halo Infinite. With the shift in Halo Infinite's release, we've decided to press play and bring in new content creators and are continuing to move this part of the program forward again for the time being. The HCS grassroots program remains the key part of our strategy and our partnership with tournament operators and content creators is critical to the long-term success of the competitive Halo ecosystem. So it's great to see this program get updated, guys. I was kind of wondering what was going on with it, because like I said earlier, the last update was back in June of 2019. So it's been a while coming, pretty much. And it's great to see that this also kind of, they have a plan to potentially have this line up with the release of Halo Infinite, meaning that this was supposed to happen probably like during the summer months, but then it got delayed. Like everything else with involving Halo right now, pretty much. And so could this possibly mean that we might see like a release of Halo Infinite in the spring? It would be weird, I think, to just kind of add these new content creators with the game like in a fall release time frame, or some version of Halo Infinite releasing in the fall. To me, for them wanting to press play on this makes me think that a spring release is most likely as well. I mean, this also kind of thing ties into the recent pro teams that have announced, you know, their rosters for Halo Infinite. I wouldn't think they would announce the rosters like a year in advance. So the new people added to the program here, guys, we have Australia, Halo Australia right here, which is a tournament organizer in Australia. Australian community is a small but very strong community over there. Hopefully they try to build things up over there, especially internationally. Halo needs a lot of help. We have Lady Echidna, who's a very popular streamer. We have Mint Blitz, who, if you guys don't know anything about Halo 5 montages or anything on Twitch, you definitely need to check him out. The guy just gets clips like it's nobody's business. We also had Trunks, who is a popular streamer as well. Mainly streams Halo 3 content, but great streamer as well. I've subscribed to him a couple times on Twitch. And you have Real Life Spartan, probably one of the most wholesome guys you'll find on Twitch, guys. And so these are very awesome content creators. I highly suggest go checking them out. A link to this post will be in the description down below, which will link you to everything they have. If you guys want to be a part of the application process, you can sign up. If you're an up-and-coming content creator, check this out. Learning November 6th, applications for content creators will once again be open until December 11th. Essentially, just go to halo.gg/grassroots, sign up there, and you get to hopefully get a chance. So these additions are fantastic additions. I agree with every one of these people. I've met some of these people in real life, and they're great people, so very excited for them to be able to join in with this program. And then we do have some more news of potentially more people leaving 343. I'm sure many of you know that Chris Lee was recently announced that he has left the project of Halo Infinite, though he's still employed by Microsoft, but currently not part of the 343 team anymore. So this also brings up more concerns about, well, what's going on there? Well, Joseph Staten and Pierre Hintz have replaced his job. So he's basically doing the job of two people. Joseph Staten is going to be the lead on the campaign side of things, while Pierre Hintz is going to be on the side of the multiplayer side of things. If you don't know who Pierre Hintz is, he's part of the production team for MCC. And he basically was one of the leads that helped bring the MCC from the grave up to where it is right now. So, you know, he's done some good work with Halo, and obviously Joe Staten is a Halo legend. Can't go wrong with him. Now, why do I bring up saying that there's going to be more people leaving 343? Well, recently I first heard this news of just like shakeups happening within 343 from Brad Sams, and he just stated out saying, heard some rumors going around that there's gonna be some shakeups at 343 happening, but I'll wait to say it until it actually happens about more detailed kind of stuff. And then literally like 2 days later, Chris Lee is announced that he leaves. So makes me think that, you know, Brad Sams, definitely who is a bit of an Xbox and Microsoft insider kind of person, would have some more connections. Twitter user of Jez Corden tweets out here saying, me and Brad Sams heard same a while ago talking about the departures at 343. There may be other major personnel changes coming down the line as well, so watch this space. And Brad Sams replies to that saying, one day our conversations will end up in the video game archives as a statement of record. To add on top of what Brad Sams mentioned, Jason Schreier, who's the guy who broke the story of Chris Lee leaving, tweeted this out in a reply saying, I can confirm, based not on assumptions, but on conversations with developers, that Halo Infinite has been having development issues for a very long time. Development issues have kind of come up recently, and you know, there's been mixed reviews. You know, some people on like Glassdoor reading reviews and stuff like that. It sounds like the main thing is with 343 and Halo Infinite's development is that the coding that they work with is kind of messy and old, pretty much. But it seems like the people that are working there, like the personnel, are fun to work with and good people, but maybe just like the brass tacks of the game development itself is a little bit dated or in some way or another. You know, the Subspace engine isn't a complete remake of an engine. It's taking down the current Halo engine down to its basement level and then building on top of that. So I think what they're doing is mainly adding in new systems to have better workflow rather than actually rework the system of how it may actually function. Which then makes me believe, so are there gonna be other Avenger people leaving 343? I mean, potentially. The fact that Halo Infinite missed the deadline for the Xbox Series X launch is a big hit, and you know, business is business, and if you don't hit deadlines, problems happen and people lose their jobs kind of situation. And I think you might be kind of seeing something similar happening. Now, this really kind of depends on whether or not Microsoft views the failures of Halo meeting the deadlines as a game development issue, or is it a 343 as a whole issue? Now, if it's a 343 as a whole issue, I think Bonnie Ross might be on the chopping block, guys, which, you know, she's been there since the inception of 343, much like Chris Lee. And if they view it as 343 as a whole mismanaging Halo, I mean, Chris Lee is a person who reports to Bonnie Ross, and then she reports to Matt Booty, who's part of Microsoft's gaming side of things. So we could see Bonnie Ross go, which would be pretty scary to think about, to have such big shakeups at 343 before the launch of the biggest game they've ever created. Or if they view this as a game development issue and not necessarily a management issue when it comes to that, because Chris Lee was the head of Halo Infinite. He was the top guy of Halo Infinite. Everything else below him is game related. So if it's game related, we could see people below Chris Lee going. If it's 343 related issues, we see, I would think Bonnie Ross would be on the cutting block. Of course, this is a developing story. We'll definitely let you guys know on this channel if anything else happens within this current sphere, because it seems like some people are getting the chopping block, so that's kind of spooky. What are your guys' thoughts on the grassroots program? Are you excited? Are you signing up? I know I'm definitely gonna be updating my profile, that's for sure. Do you think we'll see more people leaving 343, some higher ups, possibly Bonnie Ross getting the axe? I don't know, guys. Again, we'll stay up to date with all this stuff going on. If you missed any news or information from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right here. I got a link to all my news and informational videos if you missed anything for the last couple days or so. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you on the next video. Peace out.